This is what happens to current in a normal conducting wire. But imagine using superconducting wires. It wouldn't be this inelegant. Superconductors are any materials which below a critical temperature provide zero resistance to the current passing through them. But the only catch is these critical temperatures of materials are very low and yet to be found at room temperature. At temperatures above the critical temperature, these metal atoms are vibrating in their position. So when an electron goes through the lattice, it collides with these metal atoms and loses energy. This is called resistance. This energy is recuperated as heat energy. At temperatures below the critical temperature, the metal atoms are said to be frozen in the lattice, and these metal atoms are not vibrating. The electron can go through the metal lattice without colliding with any of the metal atoms. As there is no energy loss during the transmission of the electron, it is concluded that the conductor gives zero resistance at temperatures below the critical temperature. Let's dig deeper into the BCS theory. But first, we have to understand three concepts.
What are Cooper pairs?
Cooper pairs, as the name suggests, are a pair of two electrons. You might have a doubt how it is possible that two negatively charged electrons form a pair, but it can simply be explained as: imagine the pair of electrons as one electron with spin down, the other electron with spin up. The spin of the system goes to zero, and hence it will act as a stable boson, and the pair can exist peacefully. The whole lattice is made up of positive metal atoms, so it can also be considered as the interactions between the two electrons with the influence of the positively charged lattice, or it can also be understood as the photon energy being used to make a stable bond between the two electrons, hence forming a Cooper pair.
What are phonons? Phonons are the energy of the vibrating metal atoms or the energy of the vibrating metal lattice.
What are fermions and bosons?
Fermions are subatomic particles with non-integral or non-whole-numbered spins like half or minus half. Examples are bosons are particles which have integral or whole-numbered spins like 0, 1, 2. Examples are protons. The other difference is, fermions follow the Pauli's exclusion principle, while bosons do not follow the Pauli's exclusion principle. The Pauli's exclusion principle is very simple. Just imagine a hotel named Pauli's Hotel. There are four rooms. If four bosons come to the same hotel, they do not mind sharing the same room, that is, they do not mind sharing the same energy level with the fellow bosons. But imagine there are four fermions. Each of the fermion will ask for a separate room. That is because fermions cannot occupy the same quantum level or the same energy level as the fellow fermion. The BCS theory can be explained in two ways. Explanation 1. Imagine that there is a Cooper pair here. As the head electron moves through the lattice, we know that the electron is negatively charged. So these two positively charged metal atoms get attracted towards the moving electron. As we know, the lattice is spring-like, so these two go back to their initial positions. But they move back so quickly that they leave a positive cloud over here. So the other negatively charged electron is attracted towards the positive cloud, and this continues. Explanation 2. Now imagine two electrons on either side of a lattice. As one electron moves inwards, the metal atoms get attracted towards the moving negative electron and move back, leaving a positive cloud as previously stated. The second electron gets attracted towards the positive cloud. The electron moves in the direction of the positive cloud, but as it moves, it creates a distortion in the lattice similar to the first, creating a positive cloud, and the other electron gets attracted toward the positive cloud while the other goes to the opposite side.
I prefer the second theory better, or the second explanation better, only because of two facts. And the first one being, because of the charge neutrality maintained on any two points in the lattice, as one electron moves from A to B while the other electron is moving from B to A. So charge neutrality is maintained.
The electrons are placed at a distance and it reduces the repulsion between the two electrons. And the reduced repulsion explains the phonon interactions better.
Lesser energy is required to hold the electrons together.